الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولي الصالحين، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم على سيدنا محمد الذي أرسلته رحمةً للعالمين. أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله. Allah Azza wa Jal has brought upon us a new Islamic year. The Islamic year that we are in right now is 1435. And this Islamic year brings in the month of Muharram. And Shahr Muharram is a very important month, inshallah. If people can move forward, because people are coming in, move forward, inshallah, make some space here. Move forward, please, inshallah. Make some space. So this year is a new Islamic year. And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam has explained to us that in this year, in this first month, Muharram is a very important month. And its ajr is great. Its reward in this month of Muharram is great. And it has a great day that on the 9th and the 10th day of Muharram, which is next Wednesday, and especially next Thursday, inshallah ta'ala, is a very important day that our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam encouraged us to fast. And we're going to talk about the importance of this month and the importance of next Wednesday, and specifically the importance of Yawm al-Khamis next Thursday, inshaAllah ta'ala. So our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam in a hadith narrated by Imam Muslim said, أفضل صيامي بعد رمضان شهر الله محرم. The best fast after the month of Ramadan, if you want to fast 8 months and get reward, the Prophet said the best fast after the month of Shahr Ramadan is this month, Muharram. This month is the best month to fast in, as the hadith narrated by Imam Muslim mentioned. Like, what's so special about this month that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam is encouraging us to fast in this month? The Prophet said, on a hadith narrated by Ibn Abbas, and it is narrated by Imam al-Tabarani, that من صام يوما من المحرم فله بكل يوم 30 يوما. That if someone fasts in this month, let's say you're going to fast this Monday, which is sunnah to fast anyway, or you have a day from Ramadan to make up, you or your wife or somebody else, and if you fast one of these days in Muharram, it is as if you fasted for every day 30 days. So if you fast Monday, you get 30 days reward. And if you fast Tuesday, you get 30 days reward. So every day is like a month. That's what our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam has encouraged us to do. However, we found a hadith that talks about, again in Sahih Muslim, that talks about the 10th day of the month of Muharram called Ashura. It's hadith narrated by Imam Muslim, in which Muawiyah heard a khutbah in Medina talking about this day, and he got up and said, أين علماؤكم يا معشر أهل المدينة? Where are the ulama? Where are the scholars in Medina? This day, the day of Ashura, is a day of fasting. And I'm fasting this day because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam has encouraged us to fast Ashura. And the Prophet, and he said, Sayyidina Muawiyah said, then whoever wants to fast, then fast. And but it's not wajib. It is not wajib. So in the hadith narrated by Imam Muslim, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, when he arrived in Medina, he came across some of the Ahl al-Kitab, the Yahud. And you have to understand that the Muslims lived side by side with the Yahud and Nasara. And this is something, part of our history that many people don't know, that we lived together between us, the Muslims and the Jews and the Christians. We lived, providing each one respects each other. This is part of our Sharia. So we can live along with other people, even if they're not Muslim. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, when he came across the Yahud in Medina and they were fasting a particular day, The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam found this strange and he asked them, why are you fasting? What's so important? And a hadith made by a Muslim, they used to take it as a Eid, that the women would dress up and the children would dress up and they'd be celebrating this day. So the Prophet wanted to know, why are they celebrating? Because the Jews, some of their practices were still correct. They still followed the teachings of Musa alayhi sallam. So our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam asked them, what is it you're doing? Why are you fasting today? Why is this ihtifal? Why are you celebrating? Why are everybody dressed up celebrating like Eid? And they said, this is the day in which Fir'aun, the Pharaoh, was drowned in the River Nile when Musa alayhi sallam crossed the River Nile with his asa, his stick, and he put his stick in the River Nile. And the River Nile split into two parts, and Musa alayhi salam and his people went through. And then Fir'aun went through and he died. He was drowned. So they say that because of this day, نحتفل, we are celebrating the sin of Musa alayhi salam and the Jews being saved. We are celebrating this day. Why? Because if it wasn't Allah drowning Fir'aun, we would be, Musa would be destroyed and nobody else from our people would be around. So we're shukran lillah, we're going to ihtafal. We're going to celebrate and we're going to fast this particular day. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, upon hearing the wisdom, the hikmah of why they were doing this, he then gave us a guideline. And he said, فَنَحْنُ أَحَقُّهُ أَوْلَى مِنْكُمْ مُوسَى. We, ma'ashar al-Muslimin, we have more rights and we are more closer to Musa alayhi salam and his teachings than you are. And we have more right to be celebrating and we have more right to be fasting than you. So the Muslims then began to fast this particular day. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam ordered the Muslims to fast as well, like in this Amr that ليس للوجوب لكن للاستحباب. This order is the order of recommendedness and not the order of obligatoriness, as the ulama of Sharia know that when the Prophet orders something to be done, it could be على وجه الاستحباب or على وجه الوجوب. And only the people of fiqh will know this, what this means. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam began to fast this day, and in a hadith made by Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, he said on this day, the 10th of Muharram, which is next Thursday inshallah ta'ala, a hadith narrated by Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, which says that the safina, the boat or the ark of Sayyidina Nuh reached dry land after being many, many days in the ocean. It finally reached dry land and they came out to the boat, and it was also the day in which Musa was saved. And because of this, Imam Ahmad mentions in the hadith written by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam that Sayyidina Nuh also fasted, shukran Allah, because he reached dry land, and Sayyidina Musa also fasted because his people and himself were saved from Fir'aun. And how many people nowadays, they need to be saved from Fir'aun, either corrupt leaders or Fir'aun in the house oppressing his wife, or Fir'aun on his children. We have many Fir'auns these days, different Fara'ina. We have Fir'aun in the leadership in countries oppressing people, and we have Fir'aun in the home oppressing his wife and oppressing his children. And we have children who are Fir'aun as well, oppressing their father and oppressing their mother. MashaAllah, Fara'ina kathir. We have many Fir'auns in this day and age. And some people are Fir'aun with themselves. They oppress themselves by not fasting the days of Ashura, which is next Thursday. However, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, when the Sahaba came and they had a problem, and they said, Ya Rasulullah, this is the day, يُعَذَّمُونَهُ الْيَهُودُ وَالنَّصَارَى. This is the day in which the Jews and the Christians, they make this day a special day, and we are told that to make ourselves distinct and different from them. So our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them that if I am to live until next year, inshaAllah ta'ala, I'm going to fast the day before so that we are different from أهل الكتاب. That's why the ulama have said that you recommend to fast the day before Ashura, which in other words we fast Thursday and Wednesday. Thursday is Ashura and Wednesday is Tasu'a. So fast these 2 days inshaAllah ta'ala. In the hadith the Prophet said the reward if someone fasts this day Ashura, his previous sins are forgiven. يُكَفِّرَ سِنَةَ الْمَاضِيَةَ. His last year's sins are forgiven. Now you would ask, well, why يوم عرفة يُكَفِّرَ سِنَةَ الْمَاضِيَةَ وَالْآتِيَةَ. That يوم عرفة, when we fast, last year's sins and upcoming year's sins are forgiven. Why is يوم عاشورة only last year's sins? Why not next year's sins as well? And the ulama have said this is because فضيلة نبيكم محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم شهر عاشورة شهر موسى ويوم عرفة شهر نبيكم محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم ونبيكم محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أحب إلى الله عز وجل. The ulama have said that why is يوم عاشورة only 1 year, the previous year's sins are forgiven, ولكن يوم عرفة last year's and upcoming year's sins are forgiven. The ulama have said this is because Allah, he loves the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi. He's more closer to the Prophet. The Prophet is higher in darajat than other Prophets. And that's why he's favored. فَضَّلَهُ sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi. يُكَفِّرَ سِنَةَ الْمَاضِيَةَ وَالْآتِيَةَ. فَهَذَا يعني كَنْز مِنْ كُنُوز. This is a treasure from the treasures for the Ummah, inshaAllah ta'ala. And this is for the people who understand, inshaAllah. So fast Wednesday, inshaAllah. And fast the Thursday specifically, inshaAllah ta'ala, your previous sins are forgiven. And the ulama say, what does this mean, that your sins are forgiven? It can mean that either your sins are wiped away, or that you have hifd from doing sins. You're protected from doing sins. And some ulama say that if you fast your mu'arifah, and Allah yataqabbalha minka, that Allah accepts your fast, your mu'arifah, and your previous sins are forgiven, and your upcoming years are forgiven, then what's the point of fasting your mu'arifah? Ashura, the ulama have said that it may be that the sins of your children and of your family may be forgiven if you fast that day. And this is fadl Allah Azza wa Jal. This is from the merit of Allah Azza wa Jal. Ya'ti man yasha. So please, inshallah, make the most of these days, inshallah, and try and do some good works in these days specifically. And tell your family when you go home, tell your wife, and tell your daughters, and tell your sons who are able to fast. We're going to fast next Wednesday, and we're going to fast Thursday, and you make sure you tell them why you are fasting this day, inshaAllah ta'ala. عباد الله يعلموا أنه لا ينفع للإنسان في هذا الزمان مثل في خصال الصدقة في السر والإجهال واستغفاري.